renegade and plus, I've been living in Brooklyn. I love it, I enjoy it. I saw the voice of Brooklyn, and now I'm seeing the best of Brooklyn. This is a place that has transformed for the better. And I'm enjoying it. I hope you also enjoy it.
Yeah. You live in this neighborhood now?
I'm retired now, so I usually stop by on a daily basis. My cousin really follow. She's right here in Sterling and Washington. I kick it. Enjoy nature, enjoy people.
Yeah. Tell me a bit about what Brooklyn was like in the 70s.
It was a fit. Where we're standing right now, even across the world. Wake in the morning, you ask how many died. It's all blood, killing, drugs. Name it. But, like you know, and I know, nothing stays the same.
Well, I go right over here in Greenpoint, which they used to call the Garden Spot of the World. We grew up there. We played all the scoop games. We played all that. We played Ring-a-Lario, where you get two groups of people, and then you make like a gatehead up to jail, and then you capture the other people, you put them in there, and then when you get them all in there, then you win. But if anyone could get into that jail, they could release the other one. Oh, it was a lot of fun. Kick the Can, we played. Johnny and the Pony. Snoopball was a big game. You hit the, like, over here, you put the field out over there in the street. Of course, we'd be playing when the trucks were off for the weekend, like down by the docks. We hit the ball off the point over here, and there would go a single, a double, triple, home run. So you played a game like a regular baseball game. We played that, and then the school was over the same, you know, you go, you get your homework. Me, I was very good. On Friday, I'd say, I got the weekend off to do my homework. And Saturday, I'm playing with my friends. Sunday, all the good TV programs I want to do it Monday morning. So, Bob, we punch ball, kickball, you know, punch football, regular football, basketball. We didn't have these little video games, computers, and all that kind of stuff. Oh, here comes Gracie. Yeah. I said, so don't cry. Everything is all right. What? They're beating you up. What? What did you say? What? No, they're not beating you up. You got it made in the shade.
The village today has totally changed. It was, you can't afford it today. You used to be able to afford the village. The older people are being phased out, which normally happens in any gentrified area. It was an amazing place to hang around as a young teenager, young adult, but the jazz clubs are gone, the good places to hear music without costing a fortune are gone. The same old story. Because it's still a quaint little town, or town feel, a lot of the very wealthy well live in this part of the city. A lot of people who are new to the city don't really realize how special this place is, but you can't afford it now.
My name is James Barry, B-A-R-I, really pronounced Barry. I am born, raised, and still live right here on Mulberry Street. Parents were born here also. Grandparents came from Italy. One from Bari, and the other one from Palermo. I could go back as far as about 1954 or 55. I remember going to kindergarten in St. Patrick's School, a couple of blocks up from here. And I was also an altar boy at St. Patrick's Old Cathedral. This used to be Little Italy, as far as the eye could see, north, south, east, and west. I grew up thinking there were only Italians in the world, and there were any non-Italians at the time. But this took a dramatic change back in the 70s. There was a very, very huge influx of Asians in the country, especially into New York. At that time, I am second generation born here. At that time, second generation, when you got married, you moved. You went to Jersey, Long Island, and that made all these apartments that you see all vacant at the time. At that time, the rent was between $30 and $40 a month as the rent. There was no rent roll. The buildings weren't worth $30,000 or $40,000. The agents offered the landlords cash, maybe $40 or $50. They took the money and ran. The same buildings now go anywhere from $7 million, $9 million. I still maintain my apartment, my grandmother's apartment. It has the toilet in the kitchen, bathtub in the kitchen, but it's rent control. I'll never leave. And that's basically what happened. And that, there are no more children down here. What you see now are people walking dogs. There are no more children. There's no more families. People come in here, live for 6-7 months at a time, maybe less, and they move on. It's not like us as families that live here forever and ever. Corporations bought up most of the buildings now. And when your leases are up from the commercial properties, they're doubling and tripling the rent, which is a nice way of saying get out. Within 8 to 10 years, the most, Little Italy will be gone. But I'll be here.
My name is Kathleen Chalpin, and I lived in the village for 20 years, from 1995 to 2016. And then my family and I moved to Brooklyn. And I must say that in the 20 years that we lived in the village, it began to lose its character. It's rapidly turning into a kind of gold coast. And a little bit kind of, I don't know, honky-tonk. On the other hand, on the side streets, particularly if you go west, you still find the village that you expected. And one of the great joys of it is the scale of it, because it's quite beautiful and built at human scale. And so I lived here for 20 years and find it much changed. I suspect that people still come and find the village, not the village perhaps that they read about, but a village that is making itself.
Came directly to Diamond District 47 Street, working with Colombian Emerald, South Colombian. And I remember was just small houses, two floor houses all over Broadway. Actually, they have like electronics and other things on the street. Today,